In order for you to replace the background of the photo on the PSD mockup that you've picked up or you've found, all you need to do is to find a PSD mockup that you like, and then you jump in on Photopea and follow these quick, simple steps to achieve and add your own picture on a mockup. So you can download mockups on websites like creativeallies.com or freepeak.com or unblast.com. I'll add the links on the description below. You're going to open from computer and you're going to find the PSD file that you would like to use. The mockup will load, and be patient with different kinds of mockups. And your Wi-Fi could also be making the loading to be a bit longer. You're going to concentrate on the layer section. So the first thing that you're going to do after the PSD mockup loads, you're going to drag your picture, your office picture, and it would add on as an office picture or whatever you've named it on the layers. So just below that, there's a background layer for the PSD mockup that was created. So you just hide the old background, and then you will automatically have a new background, which is your office that you've just added. So that's step number one. Step number two, you're going to size your office picture and tweak it to suit whatever design you're trying to achieve. Don't worry about the 3D mockup. We're going to move it to exactly where we want to move it. So what you're going to do next is you're going to make sure that your move tool is selected, and then you're going to tick the transform controls, because you would like to move and control the picture that you've just added. And also take note, it has highlighted the office layer that we're currently on. That is how Photopea and Photoshop work. They work with layers. So whichever layer you've highlighted, that's the layer you're able to edit and tweak and make your own. So you click and you slowly and ever so gently adjust your picture to exactly where you would like it to be. Once you're done with that, I would like to flip this picture so that at least my 3D logo is on where I want it to be, but you can move it most. You're a designer, you can do whatever you want. Then you're gonna click on edit, and you're gonna go to transform, and you're gonna flip it horizontally, and the picture flips like that. So that's step number one. Step number two, you're going to use the extrusion copy and the shadows copy. So each of these 3D designs that he's created for us has a extrusion, I hope I'm pronouncing this right, this English big word, and then the shadows copy, and the smaller one as well. So you're going to click on the layer that you would like to adjust, and then move it to exactly where you would like the 3D logo that you're going to replace to be eventually on that spot. So we're going to start with this one. It highlights that this is the design that's currently there. And you just click and you move it. I want it to move over there. And then I'm happy. Then you click on the shadow. And you move your shadow to over there as well. And you do exactly the same with the smaller 3D design. And that is step number two done. The last step is the normal step that we usually do. It is now to place our own logo so that it replaces the Creative Allies logo. So you're going to double click on the checkered box like that, and you're going to hide the wording from our designer with pressing the I, and then you're going to go find your own 2D logo wherever you've saved it. Drag it to the canvas itself, adjust it, and then you're going to go File, Save as Smart Object. Please be patient with mockups. Sometimes they take a while to load. Just wait. and it has converted to smart object, and then you click back to your 3D logo layer once. And there you go, there's your 3D logo on your own photo, done and dusted. If you still see the transform controls, you just untick them like that, and then you just go file and you export it as a PNG or a JPEG or whichever kind of format that you would like to export it as. You could watch next how to create your own 2D PSD mockups to be used on Photopea on this link on the video right now. I will see you on the next video. Thanks for joining.